In this particular session, we are going to discuss set theory. And basically, what is the definition of set theory? A well-defined, unordered collection of distinct objects or elements of the same type. So basically, set is a collection of an object. It may be a collection of numbers, collection of natural numbers, collection of whole numbers, collection of real numbers, collection of an alphabet. And in this way, we can define a set. Now, set is denoted by the capital letters. Because suppose we are going to mention the set of integers, then it is denoted by capital Z. And if we are going to mention the set of positive integers, then we take Z plus. And in the same way, suppose we are taking the set of natural numbers, then we take the capital N as the symbol. So sets are denoted by the capital letters, and the elements of the set are written in curly braces. In curly braces, we write all the elements of the set. Suppose we have the set of natural number, then the element of the set would be 1, 2, 3, up to infinity. Because we know that the natural number starts from 1. So the first element of this particular set will be starting from 1. Now, the elements of the set are separated by commas. We separate all the elements with the help of comma. Now suppose if we are taking, suppose X belongs to A, means that X is the member of A. Here A is the set, and X is the element of that particular set. So the element of a particular set is represented by using this particular symbol. And we say that X belongs to A, or we can also say that X is a member of A, or X is an element of A. Okay. Now if we are using this particular symbol, that X is not an element of it. So not an element of A is represented using this particular symbol. Here A is the collection of set, and X is the element of that particular set. Now the second important thing is the cardinality of a set. So what is cardinality? Cardinality is basically the number of elements present in the set. Whatever the number of elements, suppose your set is, if we are considering a finite set, then the number of elements present in that particular set would be finite. And if you are taking an infinite set, that it would be infinite. But when we are considering cardinality, then we should take a finite set. Suppose it is the, what is in definition type of view, it is the member of element in a set, and it is denoted by mod of A. Suppose A is the set, then mod of A is the cardinality of a set. Now here we have, suppose here A is the set. Now we have to check whether it is a set or not, because the elements of a set should not be redundant, it should be unique. Because suppose here we are taking that A is a set, and the elements are 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Here the elements 3 and 3 are repeatable, they are repeated, and 4 are repeated. So this particular set is not valid. It is not a valid set, because in a set the element should not be repeated, it should be unique. Now, so it is not a valid set. Now we are taking at the set as AB. B is the set, and the elements are AB, A, B, 1 and 2. Now the cardinality of this set would be, because we have 4 elements, so the cardinality of this particular set would be 4. And now suppose we have a set C, and all the elements are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the cardinality would be 4, because we have 4 elements. Now in the same way, we can represent set in this particular form also, because E is a set, and X such that X is an element of Z. Here we are X, because X is the member of the particular set, and X is a member of Z. It means that the elements of the set belongs to the integer variable. It should be integer. And there is a condition also that the value of X should be greater than or equal to 1, and it should be less than or equal to 4. Then what would be all the elements of set E? The elements of set E would be X, but here we have a condition that the value of X should be greater than or equal to 1, and it should be less than or equal to 4. So the value of X would start from 1, then the second integer we have 2, then 3, then 4. So the elements of this particular set, set E, would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So the representation, if we are talking about the representation point of view, the elements of the set can be represented in two forms. And these are known as set tabular or roster representation, and the second representation is set builder representation. In tabular representation, we are going to represent all the elements by using the comma. Suppose a set is defined, we have used a set A, and in which we have mentioned the elements, all the elements we have mentioned, that are 1, 2, then 3, 4 and 5. In the same way, in the set B, we have taken the elements, that is -4, then -2, it is set of integers. So from we have mentioned it dot, it shows that the elements of the set are up to -infinity. And here dot represents that it is up to +infinity. Now we have taken -2, -4, -2, then 0, then +2 and then +4. Actually it is set of even integers. Now the third set is C, and in which in this particular set we have the elements A, B, C and D. In this particular tabular representation or roster representation, actually the elements are mentioned directly. We write the elements directly in the suppose it is set of integers, then we write that 1, 2, 3 are set of integers. So we can take also the negative element, that is -4, -3, -2, everything else. Now the second way of representation is set builder representation. In this particular representation, actually we mention in the form of variable, and then we give a particular condition on that variable, that the suppose we are taking this particular set builder representation. Now we are taking the set A is equal to X, such that here we are mentioning the from where X belongs. We are mentioning that also. Set A is equal to X. It is a variable. X is a variable, and X belongs to natural number. And we are in this particular set builder representation, we are mentioning that from where X belongs. It means that if X belongs to natural number, then the elements of the this particular set would start from 1 to infinity. Now we have also a condition, and X is less than 6. So using this particular set builder representation, we can easily find out the elements of the set, and it would be X. And X belongs to natural number. We know that natural number starts from 1 up to +infinity. Now we have another condition, that X less than 6. It means that the elements of this particular set would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It would not be 6, because we have a condition that the elements of the set X would be less than 6. Now take an example of second set, that is B, and B is equal to 2x, and we have a condition that such that X is an element of capital Z. Now we know that the elements, actually we know that the what are capital Z, because capital Z is the set of integers, and we know that the range of integer is from -infinity to +infinity. So we would take an integer value. It could be -1, -2, -3, any value, and we would multiply it by 2. So the elements of this particular set would be -4, then -2, then 0, then +1, +2 up to infinity. So in this way, we can represent the set using set builder notation. And the another notation is tabular notation, in which we directly mention the elements of the set. But in set builder representation, we don't mention directly. We mention a variable and a particular condition, and using that particular condition, we are going to find out the elements of the set. Now there are various types of sets. If you are going to mention the types of set, then it can be a countable set or uncountable set. Basically, we'll discuss in this particular scenario is the finite set, because a set can be a finite, set can be a set of finite elements, and it could be a set of infinite elements. Suppose if I tell that the set of integers, then the range of the integers is from -infinity to +infinity. So it is a set, it is an infinite set. But if I mention the elements of the set, and if I mention a condition such that X is an element of capital Z, and x is less than in previous case, which in this particular case I have taken that example. Suppose here the set B is equal to 2x and x is an element of capital Z and x should be less than or equal to 6. X should be greater than or x should be less than or equal to minus 2 and it should be equal to we can say that it should be greater than or equal to minus 2 and it should be less than or equal to 6. Then in this particular case we can easily find out that this is actually we are taking the set x as an element of integer and we know that the set of integer is infinite, but by mentioning the conditions we can make them finite. So the representation of set can be finite or it can be infinite. Now we have a countable set and uncountable set. What are the countable sets and what are uncountable sets, and in our further discussion of set theory we will discuss all those parameters and we will try to find out the basic structures which are needed for our subject discrete mathematics. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.